Hey everybody, I'm Angi Smith. Welcome to Facebook Live. I work in student services at Walter State, and we're so glad to have you join us today. We're here today to answer any questions that you might have about Walter State, anything that you might have related to your classes, questions about admission, enrollment, whatever the case may be. So, as you think, as you come upon questions, or as we talk today, if a question comes to you, please don't hesitate to comment and let me know what your questions are. The first thing that I want to say is thank you. Thank you for hanging in there with us. We talked a couple of weeks ago. Not everybody would have seen that, but I did a Facebook Live a few weeks ago, and I just want to say I know it is tough. We hear from students all the time that this is not easy, right? A lot of things have changed, and you're really doing a great job. I hear from faculty and staff all the time about the ingenuity and creativity of our students, and I want to say to you, keep up the good work. You are doing good things and important things. I know that it may not be what you have chosen. We understand that, and honestly, it's not our first choice either, but this is the best thing that we could do to keep everyone safe and to also deliver on our promise to give you a quality education. So continue to do the great things that you're doing. It is not easy. We recognize that, but your education is important. You're making that a priority, and that will continue to pay dividends in the future. Let me tell you a few things about what's going on. Registration and advising are going on now. You can be advised online via Microsoft Teams, Zoom, phone, whatever the case may be. We're advising in all different ways. So whatever meets your needs best, we are happy to work with you and get that going. If you don't know who your advisor is or you have questions about advising, you can email the Student Success Center at student.success@ws.edu and they can help you find your advisor. Also, new student orientation is going on now. So if you want to be go through our online orientation, you are welcome to sign up and you can find that information on our enrollment page on the website. We have had a lot of questions about graduation and about what are we going to do for graduation and what is graduation going to look like. As you've probably guessed, we are not going to have a live graduation in May. That just doesn't seem to be in the cards, unfortunately, because the virus is still out and present, and we are being discouraged from gathering in large gatherings. But we do have a survey that's coming out. You should find it in your senator's mail today. And we want to know what your preference is. If you're a senior, what is your preference? What would you prefer in relation to graduation? So please find that survey and let us know what your preference is in relation to graduation and how we gather together and how we celebrate your big accomplishment, because it is a big accomplishment. And so we're really excited about how we can best celebrate you. The other thing that I want to let you know is coming is a master plan survey. And so our master plan survey is going to go out to all students. Really, really, really want your feedback on that master plan survey. It's going to ask you about all sorts of student spaces, and we really need your feedback on how you use different spaces in the library, or in the library, on campus. The library is included, right? But make sure you look out for that survey. It will not take long. There are going to be some great prizes, and so that should be coming your way soon. So be on the lookout for that. The other thing that we're getting questions about is our summer courses. Our summer course is going to be starting on time, and what is that going to look like? Great question. Summer courses are going to be starting on time, and as I mentioned earlier, you can register for summer courses now. We will have summer courses as we've laid out in our timetable. Those courses will start online, okay? And so you'll start online as we go forward. And as the risk decreases, then you may be asked to come in on campus for small groups. especially through the month of May. But just know those will start online as we've been doing recently, okay? As always, there are a lot of questions about financial aid. What is my financial aid going to be? What does it look like? How do I find out? MyWS is the key to your financial aid, okay? So you could go to myws.edu and log into your account, and then you can make sure, the first thing you want to do is make sure you've completed all the requirements for financial aid. If you don't have any outstanding requirements and you don't have any aid posted, email financialaid@ws.edu, okay? And I have this, we're low budget here a little bit, but I don't know if you can see, we've got financialaid@ws.edu and studentsuccess@ws.edu, okay? So email financial aid and they can give you some information on your account. If you need to turn in documents, email financial aid and they can give you a link to add documents to your account or to submit documents appropriately, okay? We know those documents have sensitive information. We wanna make sure that we do that in a sensitive manner. One of the things that I've been asked is, will the grading system be adjusted at all with the disruption of the semester? You know, we've had a lot of conversation about that, actually, our system-wide. And what has been decided is no, the grading system is not going to be adjusted. So we're going to continue on with our grading system. And there are a lot of reasons for that. One of the reasons is because it can impact your financial aid in a negative way. And there are a lot of other reasons as well. But we after a lot of debate, what we determined and what a lot of schools have determined across the system is that it is best for us to continue with the grading system the way that it has been. Now, if you are struggling, certainly reach out. And there are a lot of people that you could reach out to. If you're having problems, I strongly suggest you contact your professors. I strongly suggest you contact Student Success. You can also contact Retention Services and Enrollment Services. We are here to help. We also have tutoring services. So we are here to help. The ultimate goal is not to penalize everyone. As I mentioned previously, we all know that this has been a difficult time. We are all struggling through this time. I can't tell you how many colleagues I have spoken to today who have said, wow, I'd really just like to be back at work doing my thing. And we know that you feel the same way, right? We know it's had a huge impact on what you do on a day-to-day basis and how life works for you. And so this is not about penalizing anyone. It is about working with what we have, doing what is best for students, and moving forward in that manner. So that's a great question, Tasha. The other thing that I wanted to remind people of is that you need to be checking your senator's mail and, of course, checking eLearn. You get a grade and you're working hard and you want to keep that up. So I know we're here at the end of the semester. I know it feels like you've been doing this online thing and a lot of you didn't want to do the online thing. And I know it feels like you've been doing it forever and that there's maybe forever to go, but there's not forever to go. You only have a little while left. Finals will be coming up, and you can absolutely do this. You have made it this far. You can absolutely do this. One of the other questions that we're getting is, what is financial aid going to look like? Are we going to have extra aid in the summer? Is work study available in the summer? We do not have work study available in the summer, and we are honestly still waiting on guidance from the state and the federal government as to what financial aid, if there's going to be additional financial aid, what that looks like, how that will be distributed to students. I can tell you with the Coronavirus Relief Act, there is money in there in order to help students and to go to students. And so we're still working as a state and through the federal government regulations to figure out what that is going to look like and how that looks. So those are really good questions as well. We talked about MyWS. It's really important you make sure you have all your requirements complete, that you make sure you have all your documents into financial aid. And at this time, I have a special correspondent who has a few announcements that will be of interest to the group, I do believe.
Are you stressed, or would you just like someone to talk to? Go to the counseling center webpage and you can chat with a counselor. Do you need help in classes? Tutoring is available. You can email tutoring at WS Education. Mm-hmm. Or access NetTutor via eLearn. Want an opportunity to win prizes and have fun? Follow Walter State Student Activities on eLearn.
So in case you didn't get all those, like I said, this is low budget. We have this information for you. So if you need financial aid, email financialaid at ws.edu. The Student Success Center can tell you who your advisor is, set up an appointment for advising. We also have tutoring at ws.edu, and they can answer any questions that you might have related to tutoring, and also give you information related to NetTutor, which is available on eLearn. You can access it there as well. A new feature that we've got is chat with a counselor. That's available from 10 to 12 every day and 2 to 4. Definitely go to the Counseling Center website on the Walter State webpage and access that. And then also, our student activities. Our student activities coordinator has been doing a great job, and you can earn some, and you can get some really great prizes for participating. So definitely follow student activities on Instagram. If you have questions that you don't know the answer to, or if you don't know who to ask, my email is angie.smith@ws.edu. Again, that's angie.smith@ws.edu. And you are welcome to email me. I will be happy to forward your request on, or to answer the question if I can. It has been great talking with all of you today. We certainly have missed you on the Walter State campus. I know I've missed the Walter State campus, just the campus itself, but we definitely miss you and all of our students. And if you have questions or concerns, if you just need somebody to talk to, if you want to know what resources are available, we are here to help you, okay? That is our number one goal, to help you. As I said, I've been really impressed. I'm always impressed with the caliber of our students and what you do on a daily basis. We know that this is not the easiest time, but you are not only surviving, you are thriving. And that just shows what a great spirit and a great group of students that we have. So please don't hesitate to reach out to us. If you have questions or concerns, we're here. We also have a great coronavirus resource webpage that you can access from the Walter State webpage. It's got a lot of community resources on it, in addition to Walter State resources. So again, don't hesitate to check out that webpage or reach out to us. Thanks again, everybody. It was good to see you, and take care.